What's up guys, today we are going to talk about what are the biggest challenges or risks associated with IoT and how does IoT affect our everyday lives. I have already made two videos about IoT where we learn what is IoT and how it works. If you haven't watched those videos, please watch and come back here. Only then you will understand this video better. So let's begin. In IoT, there are six challenges: privacy, network, power supply, insufficient testing and updating, lack of knowledge and awareness. The most dangerous part of IoT is that consumers are giving their privacy bit by bit without realizing it, because they are unaware of what data is being collected and how it is being used. With IoT devices, you will always be concerned regarding data security and privacy. IoT devices are always connected to the internet, where they are vulnerable to hacking. Network connectivity is a critical component of the Internet of Things. IoT devices rely on networks to communicate with servers, routers, and other IoT devices to perform the function they were designed for. But sometimes it may be challenging for the connected devices if bandwidth is severely limited. For example, think of bandwidth like space on a city bus. There is a finite number of seats and some people takes up more space with pets and luggage. People get on and off the bus at different times, freeing up space for others or taking up more. As the bus reaches and exceeds capacity, it becomes impossible to make room without bumping into others and interfering with their space. Same thing applies to IoT devices. Several conditions can affect the IoT systems, such as natural disasters, disruptions in cloud services, power outages, and system failures. IoT devices require a constant and continuous power supply to work properly. Smart speakers, smartphones, or home entertainment systems that have always listening voice command capabilities. The same is true for the camera-based devices performing facial detection or gesture recognition, which are always watching, and our health and fitness monitoring devices must be always sensing. Such devices always need power. It may not be easy in some cases. The market of IoT is very new and fast moving. Many companies rush to start releasing their products. Many of them don't provide timely updates, leaving them vulnerable to data theft. IoT devices should be tested thoroughly and updated as soon as new vulnerabilities are identified to maintain security. IoT is a very new and growing technology, so people do not have proper knowledge or awareness about these devices. It may also act as a security threat to users' privacy. As the new IoT devices are introduced in the market, our dependence will be more on these devices. No doubt, these devices are making our home smarter and making our life more comfortable. But more important is to improve their efficiency. If you're still watching this video, then I'm gonna give you a bonus tip. There are some basic security care that you can take if you already have an IoT devices at home. Always change the default password on your devices. In some cases, devices of the same model may come equipped with the same default password. This means that if you buy the same device as your neighbor, their device could have the same password, making both devices easy targets for hackers. Turn off any features that you don't need. Keep the device firmware and applications up to date. In terms of setting up applications on devices, review the permissions they require and limit the access given to these apps. That's it guys. So let me know if you want to see anything else in the comment below, and I'll read them as I came in. Give a like and hit the subscribe button if you enjoy this video. As always, thanks for watching.